In last lecture, we discussed about the photocopier, its working principle. Then we discussed about the construction. Now, when we discussed the construction, at that time we discussed that there is this is one transparent glass plate. Over this glass plate, we have to keep our that paper whose photocopy we want to take. And we have to place the paper in such a way so that the printed portion of the paper will be in contact with the glass plate. Then this is the optical system. It consists of few mirrors and lenses. Now after this, this is the aluminium roller. The aluminium roller is coated with selenium, and this selenium is photoconductive material. We already know that photoconductive material is a material whose conductivity rises when it is exposed to light. Now after this, this is the development tank. In the development tank, there is one roller. This is magnetic roller. Magnetic roller and aluminium roller both rotates in opposite direction to each other. For example, this if aluminium roller is rotating clockwise, then magnetic roller will rotate anti-clockwise. Here, this is the place where toner is kept. Toner is black color powder which is used for printing purpose. Right? Now, this is the heating chamber, right? Finally, the page on which we have printed the matter, that page will finally pass through this heating chamber, and the final photocopy we will get from here. So this is about the construction. Now we will discuss about the various steps which are required for making this photocopy. Steps for photocopy. First thing is we have to charge. We have to charge the selenium. SELENIUM, selenium, or you can also call it as aluminium drum. This is the first step, charging of the selenium drum. Second step is formation of latent image. Right? Formation of latent image. So this image is formed over the aluminium drum. Then third step is development. Development of latent image. So development of the latent image is the third step. Fourth step is transfer. Transfer of developed image to paper. This is the fourth step, and fifth and the last step is fixing of. These are the total five steps which are required for doing any photocopy operation. So first we will see charge the selenium drum. Now in this step, there is one wire, right? And this wire is kept at very high voltage. This is called as charging wire, right? It is placed near the drum. This is charging wire kept at very high voltage, right? And here we have this aluminium drum. This is aluminium drum with selenium coating, right? So now what will happen in step 1? This charging wire, which is at very high voltage, this charging wire will generate positive ions, right? So here you will find the positive ions. These positive ions are generated by this charging wire, right? So this is positive ions generated by charging wire. Charging wire. Now these positive ions is available here. Now in this aluminium drum, selenium material is coated. So now this positive ion is having the vacancy for the electrons, right? Because this atom has become positive ion because it has lost its electron. So this means there is one vacancy of the electrons is there in this positive ion. Same way for all the positive ion, it will try to attract the electron, right? So the electrons will be generated by the selenium, right? So now this selenium coating will generate the electrons in this way. So these are the electrons generated by selenium coating. Now these electrons will combine with these positive ions, and the positive ions will be neutralized by these electrons, right? So after some time, the positive ions will be neutralized by the electrons generated by selenium. And now, since the selenium has lost the electron, so the selenium atom will become positive ion, right? So now we will find that over the aluminium drum, this type of positive charge will be there, right? And this positive charge is due to the selenium coating, because selenium atom has lost its electron to neutralize the positive ions generated by high voltage charging wire. And due to this particular process, the positive charge will be deposited over aluminium drum, and this is called as charging of selenium drum or charging of aluminium drum. So this is the first step. So here this charge is formed over aluminium.
Yeah.
Right? So this is first step. So now we are having the aluminium drum which is having the positive charge. Okay? Now, formation of latent image. Now, in the step 2, what will be done in the step 2? Now, the page which we want to make photocopy, that page will be kept over the transparent glass, right? And that particular page will be illuminated by the light source. So, there is one lamp. This lamp will illuminate, this will, and here we are having that page, right? This is paper. Suppose on the paper we are having a printed matter E, right? So in this way, the light will illuminate this page. Now, when the page is illuminated by the light, the portion of the page where the printed matter is, that particular portion will absorb the light, and the page where there is no matter, right, where there is a plain page, plain paper is there, that particular portion of the paper will reflect the light, right? So it will be like this. So suppose this is page, and this page is reflecting, so some light is reflected. So this is the reflected light from plain portion of page, right? So in the page, wherever the written content is there, so that particular written content will absorb the light, and the portion of the page where there is no written content, where the plain page is there, so from that portion light will be reflected, right? Now this reflected light will fall over, so now this reflected light will fall over this aluminium drum, right? We are having this aluminium drum. Over the aluminium drum already it is, this positive charge is already formed over the aluminium drum, right? So now this reflected light will fall over this aluminium drum, and this aluminium drum is revolving, right? So what will happen? The portion of positive charge which will get this reflected light, that positive charge will be diluted, and the portion of the positive charge which will not get the reflected light, in that particular portion the positive charge will be as it is, right? So we will take the same example. Already we see this E letter is there. So from this page, the reflected light will be there everywhere where there is no content. Only this portion where E matter is printed, from that portion there is no reflected light, right? So over this aluminium drum, everywhere, wherever this reflected light will fall, the positive charge will be diluted, right? It will be removed. And the portion where the reflected light will not fall, during that portion, the positive charge will intact. So finally, what will happen? Over this drum, everywhere this charge will be diluted, and here you will find like this. So this E, this positive charge will intact, on this aluminium drum. Because only in this region, there is no reflected light is falling over this region, right? Because this portion of the light is already absorbed by this e-printed matter over the plain page, right? That's why no light will fall over this first portion. So this particular image will be formed over the aluminium drum, and this image is called as latent image. This is latent image, right? Because this is invisible. What is the latent image? It is an invisible image formed over the aluminium drum. So it is an electrostatic charge, right? Because this positive charge is electrostatic charge. So image is formed in the form of electrostatic charge, and this image is called as latent image. And this is called as latent image because this is invisible. So this is the step 2, formation of latent image. Now we will come to step 3, development of the latent image, right? So now we will come to step 3, development of the latent image. Now, this is the aluminium drum, and here we are having the image, right? Here we are having the image E, right? And near to this, we are having the development tank. This is now in this development tank we have one roller. Now this is magnetic roller. This is magnetic roller. And here we are having toner, right? So what will happen? This toner is having the black powder, and that black powder is negative charge, right? So the toner is negative charge black powder. So this negative charge black powder will fall over this magnetic roller, and this is rotating, and this aluminium drum is also rotating, right? Now when this electrostatic charge will come in contact with this magnetic roller, right, over the magnetic roller, the negative toner particles are there. So when this aluminium drum will come in contact with or come near to this magnetic roller, then this positive latent image will attract the negative toner particles, right? And negative toner particles will stick over these positive charges. It will stick over these, right? It will stick over this, right? So now, this image, which was previously non-visible, now it will become visible, right? And this is called as development of latent image. So this is development, right? Development of latent image. So how the development is done? Positive charge image, that is a latent image, is already there on the aluminium drum. Toner particles, which is negatively charged, it will fall over the magnetic roller. When this aluminium roller will come, when the positive charge of the aluminium roller come in contact with the magnetic roller, then the negative particles, that is powder, negative powder, will attracted by this positive latent image, and the negative particle will stick over these positive charge, and this image will become visible now, right? So now this is the step 3, is completed development of latent image. Now we will come to step 4. In step 4, transfer of developed image to the paper. Now what will happen? This is the aluminium roller. Already we are having this developed image is already there. Right? So these black color tuner particles are stitched over the positive charge. So now what will happen? A plain paper now will be allowed to pass through this drum. Now plain paper will be allowed to pass through this drum. And before passing the plain paper, this plain paper will be charged positively, right? So now this positive charged plain paper will pass through this aluminium drum. So what will happen? This plain paper is positive charged. Here the toner particles which are negatively charged is available over this aluminium drum. So these negative charged particles will be attracted by the positive charge of the plain paper. So this particles, negative particles will come over the plain paper in this way. Right? On this plain paper, these particles will transfer to this plain paper. And this is called as transfer of developed image to the paper. Right? So once the negative toner particle is on this paper, so our step 4 is completed. We have transferred the developed image on plain paper. But now, these particles are not properly sticked to this paper. It has to be sticked. So what will happen? Now this plain, now we will go to step number 5. Fixing of the toner. So in the fixing of the toner, that will be the step 5. What will be done? This is one roller and this is another roller. Two rollers are there. And there is one halogen lamp. Right? So here we are having halogen lamp. These halogen lamp will be illuminated and light will fall over these rollers and these rollers will get heated. So now the page over which we have transferred the image, that page will pass through this heated roller. Right? Once this page will pass through the heated roller, then the toner particles which are over that page, those particles will melt down and they will stick on the page. And finally we will get the photocopy. Right? We will get the photocopy. So these are the all steps which are required for the photocopy.